Once you have done your homework in the preparation phase and you have a well-funded, promising A/B test idea, the next step is to implement your experiment. Interestingly enough, that's the easiest step of the whole process, mainly because there are tons of point-and-click A/B testing tools out there. In this video, I will show you a few of these. I will talk about three categories: website A/B testing, newsletter A/B testing, and advertisement A/B testing. For every software that I will mention in this video, I will add the link below the video, but feel free to send in your favorite tools and I will add them as well. Also, I have to mention that I'm not affiliated with these companies in any way. I will just talk about the tools that I use and like. Okay, let's start with website A/B testing. I have hands-on experience with three tools. By the way, these are also the most popular ones: Google Optimize, Optimizely, and VWO. They are popular because each of them has a nice visual editor where you can create your new variations without coding. Personally, I use Google Optimize because its free version has all the features that I need from an A/B testing tool. Also, it works together with Google Analytics and with other Google products very well. For instance, you can use the goals you set in your Google Analytics project for your Google Optimize experiment too. Or you can target your A/B test audience based on your Google Ads parameters. There are many other features, and I will show them in a later video in this module, but the point is, if you don't want to spend money on A/B testing software, but you want to get a fully featured tool, Google Optimize is your best bet. Another popular choice is Optimizely. It's the industry-leading A/B testing software, and I've used it for quite a while as well. And Optimizely is slightly better than Google Optimize. Its interface is a bit more user-friendly, and it has many more features available. But I have to mention that you will use most of these additional features only when you get really advanced with A/B testing. As for integrations, you can integrate many tools with Optimizely too. They have API connections to heat mapping tools and even to Google Analytics, although that connection won't be as feature-rich as it is with Google Optimize. Well, the big question mark at Optimizely for most smaller companies is the price tag. Their current pricing is not on their homepage. You should contact sales to learn about it, but you can expect it to be a couple hundred dollars per month or more. So Optimizely tends to be the preferred choice of companies who already have a whole A/B testing team and a bigger budget for their A/B testing program. The third tool that I tried out a few years ago was VWO, Visual Website Optimizer. Honestly, I didn't like it too much. It didn't have as many features as Google Optimize or Optimizely, and it wasn't too easy to use either. Also, their current starting plan is around $200 per month. So I personally am not using it, and I usually don't recommend it for my clients or course participants either. But maybe they have improved VWO a bit since the last time I used it. So you might take a look at it, and if you like it, you can give it a try. So, I use Google Optimize at Data36, and some of the bigger companies I've worked with use Optimizely. One more thing here. Many bigger companies who have a strong A/B testing culture and run experiments continuously, sooner or later decide to build their own in-house A/B testing platform. For instance, we had this at Prezi. If you already have your own data warehouse and you store your data on your own data servers, adding an A/B testing solution to it is not that big of a project. But it's really useful if you can build your experiments natively into your product and you don't have to deal with third-party solutions like Google Optimize or Optimizely. I mean, Google Optimize and Optimizely are nice, but since they are general solutions that work for most online businesses, obviously, they will have some limitations when it comes to your specific business needs. In the Vault section, you will find a case study where I show you how I implemented an experiment on Data36 without using any of these third-party tools. And spoiler alert, it was no more than 100 lines of code. But let me talk about the newsletter and advertisement A/B testing tools too. This will be easy because whichever tool you use for sending newsletters or creating PPC ads, most probably it will have a built-in A/B testing solution in it already. For instance, I use MailChimp for sending newsletters, And with just a couple of clicks, I can send out an A and a B variation of my newsletters if I want to. The same applies for all popular newsletter services: ActiveCampaign, MailerLite, Sendinblue, ConvertKit, and so on. But you should be aware of one thing. Most of these newsletter services have built their own A/B testing solutions, and it's really nice of them, but they are not primarily A/B testing services, so in terms of sample size and statistical significance, be critical with them. Always run your backup calculations, and if you see a difference, trust your numbers. And the same goes for online advertisement. You can experiment with Google Ads and Facebook Ads. A/B testing is natively built into these products too, but the same thing applies here. Make sure that when it comes to evaluation, you double-check statistical significance and the certainty of the results they show you. Okay, this is it. A couple of tools that I like and use. Again, I will add links to them below this video, and I will add more from time to time when I find other tools great enough to make that list.